Hey guys, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the best Ford F-150 5.0 Coyote engine upgrades. So we recently filmed a video and discussed the best upgrades for the 5.0 Coyote engine in the Mustang GT. If you're looking to mod or tune your F-150 and you're looking at dynos and numbers from the Mustang GT, you might be a little bit disappointed at the end result on the F-150. That's not to say anything bad about it, but we'll circle back to those power gains and talk about what power numbers you can expect out of the 5-liter in the F-150 from these mods we discussed. So jumping right in, number one, best mod for the F-150 5-liter Coyote is going to be a tune. This can offer power gains of around 10 to 25 wheel horsepower. The higher end of those power gains is generally going to be seen with custom tuning and higher pump gas, like 91 or 93 octane instead of the typical 87 lower grade fuels. Solid power gains for just a tune, but really one of the biggest things with a tune is not only do you get those power gains, but that's also the foundation for building a more powerful 5.0 Coyote. A tune will help maximize the power and performance gains from other mods like an intake, headers, intake manifold, again, running better quality fuels. The tune is really going to help bring out the life and all of those other modifications and upgrades. Custom tuning is going to be your best bet for maximum power gains. However, the downside to custom tuning is if you then do go back and add more modifications and upgrades to the truck in the future, then you'll have to go back and have a couple revisions done on the tune if you want to maximize the benefits from these additional upgrades. So generally, custom tuning is one of those things that's best to save. Just start off with one of the base off-the-shelf maps. And once you have your truck in a good spot, you're done with upgrades and modifications for a while, then that's a good time to circle back to custom tuning, get things dialed into your specific 5.0 Coyote, and try to extract that extra 5 or 10 wheel horsepower through a custom tune. Moving on to number two on the list, this also ties into tuning, and that's converting to 100% E85 on the 5-liter Coyote. E85 generally offers the biggest power gains on forced induction engines, but the Coyote does respond very well to ethanol fuel. And that's especially true with the third gen engine with its 12-to-1 compression ratio. Higher compression engines definitely love E85 for its NOx suppression. It really allows your tuner to maximize the ignition advance and get the most power out of that. So with an E85 tune and no other mods, you can expect to pick up about 30 to 50 wheel horsepower, with those higher numbers mostly being seen on the Gen 3 Coyote engine, and some of the older 2011 to 2017s. Might only see power gains on the lower end of that, about 30, 35 wheel horsepower, but nonetheless, still very impressive power gains. One downside to E85 fueling is that it does increase the fuel flow requirements. It's a lot more demanding. Running full E85 requires about 30 to 35% more fuel flow. On the first and second gen 5-liter V8, you should definitely upgrade the fuel injectors at the very least. And a fuel pump upgrade is a good idea. It might not be absolutely required to upgrade that fuel pump, but it's kind of a case-by-case basis, depends on your other mods, what kind of power you're expecting to make after it, but still a great mod to go ahead and just make sure you have that extra safety net built in and that you're not running the 5-liter Coyote's fuel system to the very edge. A little bit less of an issue on the Gen 3 since those engines do have the direct and port injection combo. Makes fueling a lot easier for these full E85 setups and conversions. Moving on to number three on our list for the best F-150 5.0 Coyote engine mods, we have a cold air intake. And this is one of the least impressive mods we're talking about from power gains and a performance perspective. Probably expect to pick up about 5 to 10 horsepower from an intake upgrade. Nothing super impressive. It's a very common and popular upgrade just because it is so cheap, so simple to install, and it really doesn't take much. So if you're just getting into modding your 5.0 Coyote, then a great starting point is just going ahead, comboing a tune with an intake. Again, with minimal mods like that, the intake isn't going to really add much for power or performance. But as you start adding additional mods like long tube headers, intake manifold upgrades, especially if you move to forced induction, then an intake upgrade can really start to show much better power gains. Just an easy mod to recommend because it is super easy to install. You shouldn't have to go to a shop. Pretty much anyone should be able to do it at home in their driveway. It's only about $200-$300, depending on exactly what intake upgrade you go for. So a good mod just to throw on in the early stages when you're getting familiar with the F-150 and the 5-liter V8. Combining that tune with an intake is a great starting point. Not something that's absolutely needed, especially if you're just sticking with lighter modifications, but still a good upgrade to have in the long term, especially as you continue adding more power and more mods to the truck. Number four on the list here, we have long tube headers. And this is debatably the single best upgrade that you can do to a naturally aspirated 5.0 Coyote outside of major, more expensive upgrades like camshafts or excluding the E85 tuning. This is up there as one of the best bang for your buck bolt-on mods for the 5.0 Coyote and the F-150. One thing to keep in mind when you're going with long tube headers is those will remove the OEM catalytic converters. So the main two options you'll come across will be catless long tube headers and then high flow catted long tube headers. In most states, both of them are technically illegal. However, high flow catted headers will have a better chance of passing any form of emissions inspections. You should still pass an actual sniffer test, and when it comes to visual inspections, they'll see that the catalytic converters are still in place, and so that should be good for a pass there. Of course, with the catless, those are likely to fail even visual inspections since they'll look under the truck, see that there aren't any catalytic converters in place, and that will likely be an instant fail for your emissions or visual inspection. One major downside to long tube headers there. The other downside is if you're not capable or don't want to install the long tube headers on your own, you'll probably end up spending about $500 to $800 at a shop to get that job done. And it can also be tough to find a shop that is willing to do the job, just since these mods can be considered illegal and the shops don't want to be held liable or get in trouble for that. So it can be a little hard to track down a shop. And again, $500 to $800 in installation costs. If you DIY the job, it's nothing too complex, but it does take some time and take a little patience. It's kind of a tight area to work with while getting those headers in there, so it could be a little bit of a pain. Ultimately, again, this is one of the best bang for your buck mods you can get for the F-150 with the 5-liter Coyote. Very worthwhile upgrade if you can get it done. Last but not least on the list here for number five, we have two different upgrades. When you get to this point, it becomes a little more questionable and down to your personal goals and preferences with the F-150. And the 5.0 Coyote. So a couple different options you can go with at this point. One great mod is a Catback exhaust. This isn't gonna be the biggest power mod around. Probably expect about 3 to 5 horsepower from a Catback exhaust, not including the gains from the headers or that initial part of the exhaust system. But for the price of a Catback exhaust, which can run $1,000, $1,500, even $2,000 or more, obviously 3 to 5 horsepower gains are nothing impressive. So the biggest thing for doing the Catback exhaust is for those sounds, which obviously the 5.0 Coyote with a proper exhaust setup sounds incredible. Some people might think that's money well spent and very worthwhile. However, if you're mostly chasing the best bang for your buck and going after horsepower, performance, then probably skip over the Catback exhaust and those minimal power gains and look to spend the money on other bolt-on mods like an intake manifold. An intake manifold can show power gains of about 10 to 20 wheel horsepower, so another great upgrade right there. Otherwise, there are tons of different routes you can go with the Coyote. Of course, camshafts are another great upgrade. The only downside to cams is you can end up spending $2,000 plus just on the cams and associated parts, and then labor and install on that can add another $1,000, $1,500 onto that total price point. And so at that point, you're getting up into the $3,000, $4,000 ballpark, which a lot of people don't do cams on the 5.0 Coyote or the F-150, mostly on the basis that once you're getting up to that cost, you know, you're talking about cams adding 20, 30, 40 plus horsepower for $3,500, if not more. At that point, it's generally best just to save up for forced induction, spend the $6,000 to $8,000, maybe a little bit more depending on exactly what setup you go for. But at least with the forced induction, you can see power gains of 100, 150 plus wheel horsepower. So generally money much better spent than on cams unless you're diehard into maximizing your F-150 without moving to forced induction. Ultimately, that wraps up our video on the five best upgrades for the F-150 5-liter Coyote. As a quick summary here, I know we kind of talked about it being a different variant than found in the Mustang GT. So just to wrap this up with rough areas you can expect to end up power-wise from doing these five modifications. On the first-gen engine 2011 to 2014, you can expect to land somewhere around 360 to 380 wheel horsepower. If you're not going with E85, then it's going to be a little bit lower than that, of course. On the Gen 2, you can expect to land somewhere around 400 to 425 wheel horsepower. And finally, on the newest Gen 3 engine with the higher 12 to 1 compression ratio and all of those upgrades, you can expect to land somewhere around 450 to 475 wheel horsepower. So still very impressive results for the F-150 5-liter V8. But again, just don't go looking at Mustang GT numbers and necessarily expecting the same, since with these mods, the third gen engine in the Mustang GT, for example, can see end power in the range of about 500 to 520 wheel horsepower, and compare that to the 450 to roughly 475 for the F-150. So in the end, mod for mod, you'll probably end up about anywhere from 30 to 50 wheel horsepower lower than the Mustang GT equivalent 5-liter Coyote. So that said, if you guys like the video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the Ford F-150. Thanks, guys.